naked. He said, who told you you are naked? Have you ever eaten the tree that I told you not to touch it? He said, it was a woman. Now push, push, blame. Everybody want to push blame on somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. The man said it was the woman. The woman said it was the serpent. Hallelujah. You see where it's going. The woman was pushing the man was pushing the blame on the woman. Man being so sensitive or being so having so sense because you are the head of the house. For you to tell the woman that this thing you have done, God said we should not do it, but you have done it. I will not eat it. But he took it. But now the problem has come. You know why? God, now, marriage, you don't choose marriage for a woman for somebody. Because if you choose a woman for somebody, a problem, he said, you gave me that woman. Now he's blaming God. He said, it's the woman you put here. You see the point? He said, it's the woman. You, God, you put the woman here. You gave me that woman. So now if the problem has come, it was you who brought that woman to me. He pushed the woman, the problem on the woman. And the woman pushed into the serpent. Why did you have time for somebody to convince you? The devil was convincing the woman. And the woman paid attention to listen. If you listen to so many things that is going on in the world, if you watch on the television or whatever, you will see that it will convince you. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Then the woman said it was the serpent. And then God started to curse them. Hallelujah. Amen. I pray that every curse that is on us, we take it away in the name of Jesus. We use the blood of Jesus to wipe it away. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. In the first garden was talking. My brother, we are in the second garden. The second garden is what? Matthew chapter 26. From verse 36. Can somebody read Matthew chapter 26? From verse 36. Matthew 26. Is somebody there? Brother Oscar, Deacon Stanley, you are there. Brother George, anybody who is there can read faster for us because our time is fast spent. 26? Matthew chapter 26 from 36.
Matthew chapter 26, verse 36.
Yeah.
Reading from the New International Version.
Hallelujah.
Then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane. Uh-huh. And he said to them, sit here while I go over there to pray. He took Peter and two sons of Zebedee along with him.
Amen.
And he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, my soul is overwhelmed with sorrow.
That's right.
To the point of death. Stay here and keep watch with me.
Amen.
Going a little further, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed.
And did what? Pray.
And prayed.
That's right.
My father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me.
Amen.
Yet not as I will, but as you will.
That's right.
Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping.
Amen.
Could you men not keep watch with me for 1 hour? He asked Peter.
You read 46, eh?
I'm reading 49.
Okay.
Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. Could you men not keep watch with me for 1 hour?
That's right.
Peter, watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak. He went away a second time and prayed. My father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done.
Amen.
When he came back, he again found them sleeping. Because their eyes were heavy.
That's right.
So he left them and went away once more and prayed the third time, saying the same thing.
That's right.
Then he returned to the disciples and said to them, are you still sleeping and resting? Look, the hour is near, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us go. Here comes my betrayer.
Amen. You see, in the second garden, it was what? It was what?
Prayer.
Prayer. Amen.
Amen.
No conversation, no debating, no talking, no argument. But the moment Jesus went to the Gethsemane in the garden, he started to do what? He started to pray. My brother, let's start praying. Last all night, Edabamfu was saying that we need prayer in this church. not talking. You saw in the Garden of Eden, it was talking. Hallelujah. It was talking, talking, talking. The woman was talking to the serpent. He gave the serpent the chance to talk. But in the Gethsemane, the second garden, the Bible says that when Jesus entered there, he took three of them. He took three people. We need people who will pray for the church. Not people who will talk, who will gossip. Hallelujah. People who will say, I like this, I don't like this. No. It's time for us to pray for the Lord. To see how heaven will open for us. Hallelujah. They enter into Gethsemane. Jesus started to pray. He did not talk to anybody. He just picked people around him and then went and prayed. When he came back, those he left behind, they were sleeping. Are you sleeping? Are you sleeping?
No.
They were sleeping. He went for the second time again. He came, he met them sleeping again. He said, you could not wait for 1 hour. How many times do you pray in a day? Question to everybody. How many times do we pray in the day? How many times? If he asks you to pray 1 hour, you see that within 10 minutes, you see that you'll be sitting down. Hallelujah. Make a time for yourself to pray. It's not talking. In Garden of Eden, it was talking. But in the second Garden of Gethsemane, it was prayer. Hallelujah. It was prayer. Not talking. It was prayer. So if you will pray to God, all your problem, all your burden, I know my God will take it away from you.
Amen.
And he said, not my will, but the will of you, God. Sometimes our will is very bad. Our will is very bad. But when Jesus was praying, he said, not my will, but your, my Father, your will. The thing that you want to do, is it in line with God? Is it the will of God? You think you can use your own senses? You can use your own intelligence? You can use your own sometimes pride, your own pride can do everything. No, it's not like that. Now what is killing the church now is pride. Hallelujah. Everybody wants to be boss. It's not like that. A church is a church of God. Church is not for business. Hallelujah. We want to build a church for Christ, not a church for human being. And he was saying that, Lord, not my will, but the will of you, your will. The will of God. In Gethsemane, it was the will of God, not your will. You think you can do it your own? You can't. You think your strength can do it? You think I came here myself? You think nobody can challenge me? I'm educated. Fine, you're educated. Go ahead and do it. I know Bible more than you. Go ahead and do it. But is it will of God? Hallelujah. I can do whatever I want to do. It's my own body. It's your body. But Christ lives in you. So I want to tell you that the body does not belong to you. There's somebody who is special. That means Christ Jesus is living in you. So you have to maintain the body. How Christ wants it. Not how you want it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not how you want it. Because your will is not good. Hallelujah. Amen. I can do whatever I want to do. If I like, I can come to church. Fine. If you like, come to church. Nobody is forcing you. But at the end, the consequences you will face. That is what is important. Not talking and then saying, I can do whatever I want to do. But I want to assure you, if you will pray to God, that God, this church that we've started, we want the church to be booming, we want the church to go ahead, we want the church to move forward, not talking, I know that a year by this time, this place will be occupied.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell somebody, stop talking.
Stop talking.
Tell another one, stop talking.
Stop talking.
And tell somebody, pray.
Pray.
Tell somebody again, pray.
Pray.
Pray, pray, pray.